What will the weather be like today? That is a question that people all around the world ask. Will it be sunny and hot, chilly and rainy, or even bitterly cold and snowy? Weather you usually experience where you live is probably not the same as the weather for someone living in another part of the world. The specific weather patterns that occur in a certain location over a long period of time are referred to as that location's climate. The climate determines what kinds of houses are built, the types of food people can grow, and which animal species can survive in a particular area. Often, the first thing we notice when it comes to weather is the temperature, or if it feels hot or cold. Earth is the only planet in our solar system with temperatures that are known to sustain life. God placed our world the perfect distance from the sun so that plants, animals, and people could survive and flourish. The average temperature on the Earth is around 57 degrees Fahrenheit. However, temperatures can range from a frigid negative 144 degrees, all the way up to a scorching 134 degrees. After you notice the temperature outside, the next thing that might catch your attention is whether it's sunny or cloudy. Perhaps you live in a place where the climate is mostly sunny, like Yuma, Arizona in the United States, the sunniest city in the world. Yuma receives more than 4,000 hours, the equivalent of 167 days of sunlight each year. Or maybe your home is in a more cloudy location, like the Faroe Islands, the cloudiest place on Earth. Located just north of Scotland, residents of these islands can expect only about 2 hours of sunshine a day. Clouds are a good indicator of the type of weather coming your way. Different types of clouds forecast different types of weather, from fair weather days to the threat of storms. For instance, which of these two skies would make you think it's a good day for a picnic? This one or this one? Our Earth has great variation in cloud cover, and the ever-changing patterns of clouds are mesmerizing and beautiful. Another crucial component of weather is precipitation. This includes things like rain, snow, sleet, and hail. Through rain and snow, clouds distribute water across the land for plants, animals, and people to use. Snowpacks store water, then gradually release it as they melt, filling rivers long after the snow originally fell. Along with precipitation, wind has a great impact on how the weather affects us. A gentle breeze can cool us on a hot day, while strong gusts can make it difficult to walk. Wind is the mechanism that fuels our weather. It moves clouds and moisture from location to location, and is the catalyst for the weather we experience each day. Wind plays an important role in spreading seeds to grow plants around the world. Did you know that wind can make the temperature feel colder than it actually is? This is called wind chill. Maybe you've experienced this while walking outside on a blustery day. Over the course of your lifetime, you will experience an incredible range of weather. After a fierce thunderstorm, there is the possibility of the gentle beauty of a rainbow. Every raging blizzard is composed of millions of unique snowflakes, each one a work of art. And lightning storms put on a show across the night sky that demonstrate the wonder of God's creations. The study of weather gives us the opportunity to appreciate the complexity and variety of this world.